Delta State in the recent time received accolades for creation of 3 additional universities to cater to the educational need of Deltans. Not everybody seems to agree with that as a positive step. Recently, the ASU chairman, Dele Ashiru of Lagos State University, described Delta State as going into proliferation of universities without making effort at payment of workers' salaries. How would you react to that?
Well, first, in all honesty, I want to concede to the Ashiru from one of these, ASU leader from one of these universities in Lagos, his right to unionize, right? And his right to struggle for the welfare of members of his Congress. I do not deny that. I've been in it before, I'm still in it. But what was offensive was the reference to Delta State. The lie against Delta State, that Delta State was proliferating universities while unable to pay the salaries of workers. Get it clear? We established 3 universities. According to you, why should we establish 3 universities when we are unable to pay salaries of workers? It is laughable that anybody in Nigeria will say that Delta State owes workers' salaries. I've said it, if I've challenged anybody, Delta State does not owe workers' salary. As I'm here, I'm expecting November salary. Because today is 18th, soon we'll get to the end of November. It will come. I mean, my November salary is taken in Delta that it will come. Because salaries in Delta State are on first charge. We don't do anything until we pay salaries. So for somebody to sit in the comfort of his home in Lagos and weave lies against Delta State is really provocative. Now, going specifically to the university setup, yes, we had one university before in Abraka, that is the Delta State University, Abraka. Now there are 4. We didn't just wake up to say we had so much money, we needed to look for an avenue to spend the money. No. Neither did we just wake up to say, we owe salaries a lot, we want to owe more. So let us establish 3 more universities. Certainly not. Based on need, we decided to establish 3 more universities. At a time, in the past 3 years or so, the one university we had could have requests for admission in the neighborhood of 25,000. Not just 25,000 applicants, please, let me correct that. 25,000 who did well in the JAMB placement exam. Scored above 180, had Delta State University Abraka's first choice, did the most UTME, did very well, but only a little below 5,000 could be admitted. These ones were left. The following year, another set will come. Those same students who could not get about 20,000, a little above 20,000, who could not get admission, will write the exam again. And you know, when these children write the exams while in school, they do much better than when they write it away from school. And you know what frustration can do to a child? We are a responsible government, for God's sake. Let us see what we can do. Let us establish the 3 universities. And I dare tell you, even these three, cannot cope with the demand of Deltans for tertiary education. Go to most private universities in Nigeria, and you plot the population of students state by state, Delta State is just up there in the number one position when it comes to student population on a state by state basis. How can a government just sit and watch the children suffer and watch parents suffer? And we decided to do this. Now the other side of his attack was that we are owing salaries. When an ASU branch chairman makes a statement, that statement can be taken to the bank. Because it's an academic, and for you to be an ASU chairman, you must be minimum of senior lecturer. A senior lecturer is the career position in the university. At that rank, you can be acting head of department, acting dean, and acting director, and all of that. So whatever you say is quoted by all kinds of people. And that's why the Congress of each ASU branch is very careful about what their chairman says, because it rubs off on them. So he now came publicly and lied that we are not paying salaries, and then nationwide, the gross salary of the professor is 490,000 per month. You don't tell such lies. I wouldn't take him seriously if he appears before Ngige for negotiation. When Ngige knows, when the Minister of Labour knows that the gross salary of a professor in Delta State University is far ahead of that, even the net is ahead of that figure he quoted in Delta State University. But he wanted to plead to the gallery. And I'm also saying that even these three new universities were established, the lecturers there, the staff there, earned the same way Delta State University Abraka lecturers earned, which is far above what he told the public. If his university is not paying well, I will support him to struggle for good pay. He should struggle for, but he should not rubbish Delta State. He should not run down Delta State. That is almost becoming an education hub in Nigeria. So that's the take. And if he did not have information, the Vice Chancellor of Delta State University, Abraka, that he said we're not paying salaries, was the former chairman of ASU. He could have gone to him to find out how much you pay. There's a branch chairman of ASU in Delta State University, Abraka. I was for 8 years, I was branch chairman of ASU in Delta State University, Abraka. He could reach me to find out what the salary was and how regularly a salary is paid. Even if he didn't trust all these persons because they are all staff of Delta State University, the national president of ASU, Professor Sodeke, is a Delta. So the national president will know what salary members of ASU in Abraka earn. He should have found that from him. And I'm sure the national president will be very embarrassed now that a branch chairman could run down Delta State, which is a part one of the few states that pays salaries very regularly. He should not do that. He's a colleague, right? He's a colleague. He should never have done that. We just go to television and run down the state simply because governors will not want to take people who attack them on. No, but I'm sitting here, right? I know what Delta State government spends on tertiary institutions in Delta State. And when I say tertiary institutions, now we have 4 universities, 3 polytechnics, 2 colleges of education. They are paid, of course, the head school at Ofoma. They are paid regularly. And if he's saying it out of jealousy, I forgive him. If his state cannot do it and our state is doing it, I forgive him for that, but don't be too jealous. There is space for us in Delta State. They can come. That is why, as soon as these 3 new universities were established, applications started coming from outside Delta State. We cannot cope. We cannot cope right now with the applications that are coming in for persons who want to be lecturers, some who want to be professors here. Because they know when you come to Delta State, I'm not saying it's too rosy, right? But we are maintaining our own. In Delta State University, Abraka, for example, which is being replicated in the 3 new universities, as you retire, your name migrates from the regular payroll to the pensioner's payroll. Your pension is just there. You migrate from regular pay to pension. They should come and learn from us how we do these things. I'm not being jealous. Unless they want us to suspect that it's a kind of political game they are playing, or opposition game they are playing against Delta State. If you tell us what we are doing in Delta State that is wrong, I will accept it, because I want to learn. I want to learn. If you tell us there's something we are doing in the education system, whether primary, secondary, or tertiary, that we should not do, and we own up. Delta State government, we own up. Okay, thank you for your criticism. We shall correct it. But when you tell us to our face that what we are doing correctly is not correct, but we should copy you. If we copy his university, I trust my lecturers in Abraka, they will go on strike. If we decide now that this is your salary you have brought to television, let us round it down. Let us pay professors in Abraka that salary. His Congress will impeach him for causing hardship to a fellow university. So that's how I look at it. Beyond that, if a state has about 500 public secondary schools, and more than twice that number of private secondary schools. That tells you something about that state. That the indigenes of that state are education hungry. Apart from the 500 secondary schools, we are targeting 25 technical schools. There were six before this administration came on board in 2015. This administration is leaving behind in 2023 25 technical schools, state-of-the-art technical schools, one per local government. If for any reason the constitution is amended and Delta State now has 28 local governments, we will build three more. Where will these children go to? These children in the technical schools and the secondary schools, where will they graduate to? Some will find their ways to the colleges of education, some to the polytechnics, some directly to the universities. Now you look at the polytechnics we have. Why did we decide to establish a University of Science and Technology? The HND program is being phased out nationwide, meaning the polytechnics will be left with just the ND program. These people are already tantalized with technical education. They now have the ND, which is both terminal and an entry requirement for further studies. They want to go on with their educational pursuits, but the HND is no more there. They must create an avenue for them to improve on themselves, right? A university of engineering. And that's what we have done. So that those living the technical schools, those living the secondary schools, and those living the polytechnics who are engineering hungry, we come to the University of Science and Technology. Then two other regular universities. At the end of the day, Delta State would now have four faculties of engineering, four colleges of medicine, three faculties of law, four universities offering courses in environmental science, that's architecture, estate management, quantity surveying, and all of that. So why would we not be happy? Why would you believe? People are so happy. The few persons who are not too happy are those who are feeling jealous too, like our man in Lagos. Why is this university not in my village? Why is it not in my community? Why is it not in my local government? Governor Kowa, I established one in my local government. Those are the requests we are even receiving as I speak to you. Okay, please send the campus to us. We will like what we are seeing where we travel. Those in Delta State are appealing to us. We need more. Those outside Delta State, but Bele say we should not have. Now you are saying we proliferated universities. If there was no proliferation, Ashiru would not be a university lecturer. If we had only University of Ibadan that was established in 1948. University of Ibadan was established in 1948 due to need. Then by the 60s, between 1960 and 1962, we had additional Ife, Nsukka, Lagos, and Zaria. Then in the 70s, they blossomed again. Uniben joined and all the others. There are so many now. Then the states. Blaze the trail, we want to have our own universities too. If there was no proliferation of universities, where would it be? He has forgotten about that. If there is no proliferation of universities, where will he get more membership of ASU? Because now we have created membership for him in three more universities. Rather than thank us, he is attacking us without facts. That's not how it is done. When between 1948 and 1960, when Ibadan University joined Ibadan, that was a period of 12 years, right? We established our own Delta State University in 1992. Delta State University in Abraka is 29 years old. Are you saying that a university we established in 29 years ago due to need has met all the needs up to now with expanding population, great urbanization of towns in Delta State, more persons are coming in who need university education. They wanted us to remain with that one university, whereas within 12 years, there was need to replicate the University of Ibadan. No, people must be ready to make progress. We move forward, let us say, we do not move backward. I forgive the young man who made that statement because Christ said, forgive them, Lord, for they know not what they are doing. He does not know what he's doing. He spoke out of ignorance, and truly, I forgive him.